really grateful for this award. I've been working in FBK for many years now, and this really means something for me. So I'm really honored and humbled by this award. So coming to the technical stuff, I will bother you for like 12 minutes or so about planning and scheduling in temporal uncertain domains. That was the title of my thesis, and I graduated at the beginning of 2016. Actually, it was the 19th of January, actually. So let me first set up a bit the context of my thesis, that is AI planning. So AI planning is one of the oldest probably problems in the AI community. It's a long-standing problem. And in a nutshell, basically planning is the problem of automatically synthesize a plan or a strategy to control a system, any kind of system. You can imagine a robot, for instance, given some kind of system specification in form of a formal model, typically. So you do have some kind of mathematical representation of what your system can do. And you also provide the planner with some kind of initial condition and the goal to be achieved. And the job of the planner is actually to synthesize a sequence of action, a strategy, a policy, or some kind of control structure in order to drive the system from the condition it is now to the desired goal state. And as you can imagine, this is one of the basic forms of intelligence that you can think of, is basically trying to reason and to project the future in order to achieve a desired goal. And there are different kinds of applications for planning, most commonly robotics, for instance, but not only. It's used also in, for instance, web service composition and others. The context, actually, of my thesis, so there are different forms of planning that you can consider, and in my thesis, I focused on temporal planning. That is, planning in systems in which your mathematical model deals with time. You have some kind of model of time, for instance, continuous time, and your system is subject to temporal constraints, for instance, you wanna achieve your goal within a given deadline. So you are not given infinite amount of time to reach your goal, and your actions are not instantaneous, but take some time to execute. And of course, when you consider time, there are a number of issues that arise that are not present when time is not considered. For instance, when I have two actions that are being executed in my system, and those actions are executed in parallel, of course, you know, there, even in a program, you can have race conditions, the action interfere in non-trivial ways, and also here we have also temporal constraints, so the interaction between the action can modify the temporal constraints. But actually there are quite some work in the literature, so temporal planning is, I would say, mostly solved problem, and the typical idea is actually to decouple the two components of the problem. On one side, you have the scheduling, there are a lot of literature there, about basically assuming to have a finite set of activities subject to some kind of temporal constraints that you want to satisfy, and you want to find a good timing conditions for executing these actions in your systems. And the key part here is that the number of activities is fixed. Instead, so this is like component one of the solution. Component two is planning in the classical sense, so when actions are actually like considering instantaneous, so you are more interested in deciding which action you want to carry out in order to reach your goal, and then you combine them with your scheduling. So the typical solution that you have in the literature is having a planner that decides which action are going to be executed in order to achieve the goal, and a scheduler that decides when the actions are going to be executed. This is all fine, but actually there is one missing component, that is temporal uncertainty. So If you think about different situations in the cartoon, you can see, for instance, a couple of guys waiting for a bus. I mean, it's not that everything in the world is up to you. I mean, you are not the center of the universe. Some of the activities that you can consider are not under your control. For instance, the two guys waiting for the bus cannot actually decide when the bus will arrive. It's something that they can observe, but it's something coming from the exogenous world. And so we need to consider this kind of uncertainty if you want to come up with robust plans. Because if I want my robot, for instance, to achieve a desired goal within a deadline, and I don't consider that actually the speed of movement is dependent on the weather condition, I can be lucky, so maybe my plan actually works, but maybe the weather conditions are bad and my plan cannot actually work. So there are a number of ways in which you can tackle this problem. One simple thing that you can do is to consider worst case scenario. So you model in your system the worst case scenario and you plan for it. Of course, first of all, it's inefficient because it doesn't consider when you're lucky. And secondly, I also proved in the thesis that there are some situations in which considering the worst case is not possible. So you can, if you do that, you are actually creating incorrect plans possibly. You can do replanning, so you move the planner instead of generating the strategy like a priority thing, so doing it offline and then deploy only the plan on board. You actually put the planner on board of your system, and whenever something doesn't go as planned, so you have some kind of monitor that tells you, look, this action is taking too long, you actually invalidate the plan and generate a new one. This works, and many systems are actually implemented using replanning, but it's actually quite expensive, so you need quite a beefy computer on your system in order to do planning. It's a piece space problem at least. And finally, there is flexibility. I don't have much time to dig into the details, but the idea is try to generate not a plan that works for a single time point, but trying to create general plans, kind of a strategies. This is fine, and it works quite well in practice, but informally you don't have any correctness guarantee. Your planner is gonna do the best it can in order to generate flexible plans, but you cannot actually trust on it. So the roadmap of the thesis and the problem statement is the following. So we want to devise efficient techniques in which we are actually modeling the answer directly into the problem, and the kind of plan that we want to generate are formally guaranteed robust plans. So I ask my system engineer, or the guy that actually is developing the formal model, to tell me which is the uncertainty in the world that you want to consider, and assuming this uncertainty, we want to generate plans that are guaranteed to work. The keyword here is guaranteed. So we want an explicit model of uncertainty in the model, we want to guarantee actually that the plans are valid, and practically all the things that I developed are based on some kind of logical formulation of the problem in the framework of satisfactory model theory. Let's skip a bit about this example, but an important point here is that when you have a couple of actions, for instance here A and B, and you assume them to have a certain duration, so you want to model in your system the fact that you cannot control the duration of A nor the duration of B, there is not a single problem that you want to solve. You can have a range of problems depending on the kind of assumption that you do on your execution. So if you assume that you cannot actually observe determination of the activities because, for instance, you don't have a sensor for it, the only kind of plan that you can actually implement is called the strong time triggered plan, in which you basically want to start the activities at fixed time points and basically disregard the ending time points. You want to find an assignment that is so strong, that is so particular, that actually all the temporal constraints in your plan are going to be satisfied no matter what. Of course, this is quite rare in practice, but it's actually useful in some cases. If you assume that you can actually observe the determination of all the activities, what you can do is actually to create strategies, something like the one depicted here. So you have, for instance, starting some time points at fixed moments in time, and others you can actually reference other time points. So it does start immediately after A. In order to be executed, require A to be observed, determination of A to be observed, and immediately your executor is going to start B. These are called dynamic plans. And finally, this is more theoretically interested, but it's also possible to have some kind of clairvoyant executor that is called weak strategy, in which basically you are allowed to observe the future. So you want a strategy that is robust with respect to your uncertainty, but at the beginning of time, you already know what the uncertainty in the world. The difficult part here is actually to generalize. So you want a single strategy for all the possible assignments. So the following basically the division that there is in the state of the art between scheduling and planning, this is basically the three parts that I structure my thesis. So first of all, of course, it was like the state of the art, and we tried like to actually do quite a lot of work there. Now we have submitted actually a journal paper about the as a survey of the state of the art that I did in the thesis, and we tried actually to formally, let's say, put the different pieces that you can find in the literature in order to classify them, because the literature was a bit scattered there. Then I considered two different problems, so the problem of scheduling, so fixed set of activities, find the good times, and combine the two, so the problem of temporal planning. Considering the scheduling part, basically we worked in the three directions that I explained, so the three type of plans. We have some papers for each of them. In particular, the strong controllability one was one of the first work that I did. Basically, we tried to leverage the efficiency that the SMT solvers are able to to guarantee you in order to represent the times and the temporal constraints, and actually it turned out to work really well also on practical problems. Then we analyzed the problem of free controllability and mixed strategy synthesis from a theoretical point of view, and also we have an implementation of a synthesizer, so a scheduler. And finally, also the dynamic controllability, that was basically the last part of my PhD. We focused on that one, and we had very nice theoretical results. We defined which is the complexity, and we also solved some open problems there. And coming to the planning part instead, I mean, the duration of a PhD is finite. So basically, we focused only on the strong temporal planning part, so finding plans that have a fixed time point for each of the actions. And we developed a dedicated planner plus a compilation technique. So basically, you are able to reduce a problem that has this kind of uncertainty that you want to consider to a block to a plan, to a planning problem that is just a plain temporal planning problem that an off-the-shelf planner can solve. And of course, at the cost of introducing additional components into the problem. And also, we have this theoretical work in 2013 about the formalization of timeline-based languages, that is basically another kind of paradigm in the planning community. And also, basically, in my internship, I contributed to the development of this new language that I'm really excited about. It's called Animal, and the uncertainty version is called Animal. And it's basically a language with a very clear semantics, and is now being used also in NASA IMSS. Okay, so I don't have the time actually to enter into the details of all this work. I just wanted to show you a bit of the results that I presented in the thesis. So basically, this was the state of the art for strong scheduling. So when you have these junctions and you want to find a fixed endpoint for a fixed set of activities, this was basically the best technique known. And you can see on the x-axis the number of instances solved by the different techniques, and on the y-axis you have the cumulative time in seconds. And this is just the result that you obtain by encoding the problem quite naively in SMT. But then, you know, as in many cases, when you encode your problem, there are basically some tricks that you can apply. You can rewrite the encoder in such a way that the solver is more efficient. And these are actually two different ways in which you can encode the problem in order to squeeze up a bit more performance from your SMT solver. So as you can see, the increment is quite dramatic. These instead are the results for planning. This is more like a strange, so I was quite surprised when I saw this plot for the first time, because basically these are actually the incomplete technique that I developed, so you can basically ignore them for the sake of this presentation. And instead, all the complete techniques that I developed are pretty much all comparable, I would say, in this experiment. So when I analyzed it in a scatter plot, you can see it's incredibly strange. So the two techniques, those are two different techniques that I developed. As you can see, they are incredibly complementary. And as of now, I'm not completely sure how to predict whether an instance will work better with one or the other. But actually, if you combine the two, you can obtain a very efficient solver. So this was actually very interesting, the result that we obtained. And well, okay, this was another technique that we developed, that is basically a simplification. So in some cases, you can actually apply a worst case approximation of your uncertainty, and you can prove that in particular situations, these are actually sound and complete, so you can do it as a simplification. Right now, I'm working in FBK, and we are trying to actually apply this kind of technologies to industrial projects. In particular, last year I worked practically full year on this project, the ILAD project, that is a collaborative, well, first of all, it's an EIT project, so the European Institute of Technology, like the other building. And we basically developed the planning part, so the reasoning and decision part, for this application in which we have an AGV, an automated guided vehicle, inside a factory by CRF, so the basically Fiat Chrysler Automobiles, their research counterpart. And the actual robot has been actually constructed by partners in Germany, by Fraunhofer Institute and the FKI, and we instead developed the planning part using the kind of technique that I presented before. So in particular, strong planning with temporal uncertainty. And this was a very interesting application. So coming to the conclusion, because we don't want to waste too much time. Well, first of all, I'd like to stress the fact that temporal uncertainty is an important issue. I mean, my PhD was about this one, so you can imagine that I'm stressing this. somehow this is underestimated in the planning and scheduling community, but right now I have to say that we are having some kind of impact, and many groups are actually looking into this kind of issues right now. The kind of technology that I developed are mostly logic-based technologies. First of all, because in the unit that I'm working on, we're actually developing one of these logic-based solver. But actually, I proved in this kind of thesis that these kind of techniques can actually squeeze quite a lot of performances. I mean, they can be very, very competitive. And finally, the strong temporal planning with uncontrollable duration is a very powerful framework. Even though the kind of plan that you can generate are rather simple, you can actually solve a lot of problems that are otherwise unsolvable by other techniques. There are other future directions. First of all, dynamic planning, considering resources, like for instance the consumption of fuel by a car, when you want to reason about this kind of issues in planning, you need dedicated techniques. Optimization, so the kind of technique that I developed are actually finding one solution according to the constraints. You maybe want to search for the best solution according to some kind of method of your choice. And also non-determinism. So there are actions in the real world that are actually inherently non-deterministic. Roll a dice or the occurrence of a fault in a robotic action. So dealing with those can be done, but it's actually quite difficult. So it's left for future work. And also beyond synthesis. So in the whole thesis, we are concerned about synthesizing a schedule, or synthesizing a plan, or synthesizing a strategy. But those are model-based techniques. So the kind of reasoning that you can obtain is actually limited by the quality of the model that you are giving in input to the system. So having automated techniques that allows you to debug your model, to verify properties on your model, are extremely important. Before actually thanking you, I would like to thank some people also. So first of all, Alessandro Cimatti and Marco Roveri, Alessandro was my principal advisor, and Marco Roveri was my co-advisor from the ES unit of FBK. I spent 7 months at NASA Ames in Mountain View, and so I would like to thank David Smith, Mindo, and Jeremy Frank that were my supervisors there, and also this folks here that actually served as my PhD evaluation committee. So, thanks you all for listening. I don't know whether we have time for questions, but if you have, please. If not, come and